There's more, dude.
You want the personal fact?
Ah, no, I'll do it.
You got air tags on them?
Yeah.
Pointing into this part of the enclosure, what have I already done? I've already cleared it, haven't I? So it's close to the wall to get as much exposure to that angle. And then all I'm going to do is keep that barrel on that apex, just walk backwards around, keep that elbow tucked in, nice and slow, hand in the groin, all the way to the other side. At this point, then I can break into the strike ready and then make entry. What we do in the corridor and in the structure, but that'll become apparent later on. Is how we go about sort of doing that high on the door and the shot procedure on the door, doesn't it? So if we're moving around that door, we start firing multiple shots and we've stopped and our barrel's off there, that target there has got the drop on me.
Nice bows. You're so good.
Who's up there? Jumping back, yeah.
Nice. Good.
Hold front.
You got that?
Hold that. Right, back clear. Start back clearing.
with us.
Yeah, just back clear.
Back clear.
Are we engaging?
Got it. Clear. Oh,
What was that?
Yeah, I don't really have to.
Be fucking dead.
Reset yourself to that, looking at your target.
Like reset.
Hey!
That starts it.
Once you reset, lads, safe and safe up here, back up the ring.
Yeah, so my name is Captain Nathan Johnston. I'm from a small town in St. Charles, Minnesota, and I'm currently the Marine Corps Security Force Battalion Banger RTT Platoon Commander. So the purpose of this exercise is to work with our partner nation, the British Royal Marine Corps, and work with a unit that does a very similar mission set that the Recapture Tactics team does, and it allows us to build upon relationships and share our different tactics, techniques, and procedures. Yeah, so I was lucky enough to be able to send a group of the Marines for the first phase where the Brits come over to the U.S. And I think over there they got a lot of hands-on shooting time, short bay, and really got an introduction to the British CQB tactics, which are pretty similar, but there's definitely some differences, and the guys were able to take that and bring that back to the platoon and potentially implement that into our SOPs, as well as just building relationships with the Brits and also with the RTT platoon from Kings Bay as well, which we actually don't have an opportunity to interact with a whole lot. So some of the biggest differences I've noticed, which are just very, very minimal differences in just kind of the way that they work through some of their CQB tactics and techniques, getting real into the specifics, just different dominant positions and enclosures, and the way they solve some of the problems is a little different. And I think that there's a lot of value in that and potentially mixing the best of both the U.S. tactics and the... Yeah, so I think that this exercise is good because, you know, I think having the Marines come here and show the Brits how we do some of our things and having them show us, you know, it allows both units to kind of take a look at how they've been operating in their own specific environment and potentially, you know, taking some of our tactics and plugging it into their SOPs, as well as us using some of the techniques that they've taught us here over the last 2 weeks. Yeah, so I think this exercise could improve in the future with, you know, just getting some of the same guys back again and getting new guys again in the future. I think one thing that we talked about maybe utilizing in the future is getting some of the specialty positions, so some of the designated marksmen and breachers, getting our designated marksmen and breachers to work with their DMs and breachers and getting a little bit of a look at, you know, how they utilize their tactics. This exercise was mostly focused on marksmanship and interior tactics, but I think adding those specialty, you know, skills into the mix in the future iterations would be extremely beneficial. So one of the biggest things I think I'm going to take away from this as a platoon commander is their use of sims was pretty elaborate. They threw a lot of different scenarios out there with role players, and we do a lot of that, but you know, a lot of times we'll just kind of jump into live fire. And after running through some scenarios with these guys the last 2 weeks, I think there's some hidden value in the sim round training that I personally am going to try to capitalize on going forward with the platoon. I also think that the guys took away, you know, little bits and pieces of the tactics here and there that we'll probably end up implementing into our current platoon standard operating procedures. Okay, so for the phase two of this exercise, we started off Kings Bay and Bangor kind of splitting into two different groups, and we had one of the British corporals kind of running our guys through just the basic five-step or the basic CQB interior tactics that they utilized throughout their schoolhouse, while the other group was just working through some close bay marksmanship, running through some of their different drills and with utilizing their weapons, which very similar, a little bit different. And then we kind of brought it all together and did a little competitive shoot, which was a lot of fun. And then the rest of the second week, the rest of the exercise consisted primarily of utilizing their shoot house, which is a mock-up of their operational area, which is all very, very similar to the job that we do both at, specifically at Bangor and Kings Bay, and running through different scenarios, using some of their techniques and tactics, throwing some of our techniques and tactics in there, and kind of accumulating at the end with a force-on-force exercise with having some of the British Royal Marines, actual RTT, you know, running different scenarios for the Marines to work through. I think one of the other benefits of this exercise is that, you know, we have Security Force Battalion Kings Bay and Security Force Battalion Bangor, and we really don't get to do a whole lot of cross training. So exercises like this, I think, bring both groups together. And I was working with the Kings Bay platoon sergeant and building some connections there. And I think just building some of those relationships between the two units is huge. Hopefully we can keep fostering that going forward. As well as the Brits talked about having an opportunity to potentially send some Marines over to some of their schooling in the future, which would be an awesome opportunity to try to exploit in the future.